AP exams are the advanced placement exams that can enable you to graduate early from college as an undergraduate student. So in this video, I will be talking about why you should take AP exams and how you can prepare for them. So let's get started. So talking about why you should take these AP exams, and yes, I did save around $20,000 in college because my tuition fee was around $35,000 and I saved one semester, that is half year of college, and that counted as $20,000. So now I was able to save that much time, or I was able to save that much money, because I took four AP exams including AP Calculus BC, AP Chemistry and AP Physics C, that included AP Magnetism and AP Mechanics. So that counted as around five courses in college, and I was able to skip that because I got minimum four in all of these four AP exams. And it is your responsibility to check at your university what's the minimum AP requirement for that college. For example, if you look at the AP requirement for AP Physics at Georgia Tech, that is 5 out of 5, but at Georgia State University it is minimum 4 out of 5. And if you get 4 at Georgia State University, then you will be skipping that at GSU, but if you get 5, only then you will be skipping at Georgia Tech. And when you skip that course at the university, you will not be taking it. So that's the reason I saved a lot of money and I skipped 5 courses. That means I skipped one semester. And I will be graduating in 3 years instead of 4 years because I took these AP exams. And on the top of that, I also took some overload of courses because I took sometimes 7 courses instead of just 5 courses. So now let's talk about how to register for these AP exams. So you need to first go online and select the center where you will be taking these AP exams. And these AP exams are offered in 15 cities all over India. And you will first have to select the city where you want to take these AP exams. And after selecting the city, you will have to pay the money at the center. Yes, you cannot pay the money online. So I did the same. And luckily, my center was in the city I was living in. So I just went there and paid the money by cash, and then I was registered. So now you have to register for these AP exams by March 19. That's the deadline in India, because this is just once in a year opportunity that you have been given, and these AP exams are going to start in May, and the latest AP exams are coming in this year, May 2019. So make sure you register by March 19. Now I will recommend all of you to take AP Physics C, AP Chemistry and also AP Calculus BC, because for most of the STEM majors, including biology, they will be using these courses in college, and you will be able to skip these in college. And you can also take other AP courses like environmental science or even AP English, because those will be some mandatory courses that you will be taking in college as well. And you have to check if your AP scores will be accepted at your university or not, because some universities may not accept the score, or some university may only accept 3 AP exams. So you have to check before you take your AP exams. And the syllabus for these 3 AP exams, including AP Calculus BC, AP Chemistry and AP Physics, is going to be very similar to what you're going to study in grade 12 non-medical. So you can definitely take them after it, because you will be already prepared for these exams after your board exams are over, and after that you'll have 1 month in which you can revise the syllabus and you can do better in these AP exams. But if you think that you cannot take these 4 AP exams in just 1 week, then you can distribute them evenly. Maybe you can take some in grade 9, grade 10, grade 11 and also in grade 12. So you have a couple of these years in which you can take your AP exams. So take these AP exams when you feel the most prepared, and I personally took these AP exams right after my board exams were over. So my board exams were over in March 2016 and I took these AP exams in May 2016. So now talking about how to prepare for these AP exams. So now the number one step is going to be to take a mock test so that you can see how much you are scoring right now and whether you will be able to perform well in your AP exam back in May or not. So if you are actually doing well in your mock test, or if you are at least getting 3 or 4, then you can definitely put that to 5 in the real exam. So there are some calculators, some AP exam calculators. I'm going to link that in the description as well. So in those calculators, you can put in your scores. So there are subjective questions in AP exams and also multiple choice questions. So subjective questions are also known as free response questions. So in those calculators, you can put in your scores for those free response questions and also for your multiple choice questions. And after you put in how much correct answers you got, you will be able to check how much you scored in your AP exam in the practice test. So on that website, just put in that and you will find out whether you got 3 out of 5 or 4 out of 5. And after you have found out how much you score, and then you can plan to take that AP exam in that year. So after you have taken your first mock test and after you have tested your performance for the first time, now it is the time to boost up your score. So now I will recommend you to solve all the chapters for that AP course in your Barron's workbook. And on the top of that, you should also practice some questions on the College Board website. Yes, College Board website also provides you with some previous year AP exam questions, and those are with answers, so you can definitely try them. And you should keep on practicing until you have maybe 15 days remaining for your AP exam. And once you have 15 days remaining, I will recommend you to solve one mock test for each of your AP exam every day, so that you can see that whether you're getting at least 4 or 5 in that particular AP exam or not. And if you're getting 4 or 5 in the last few days, then you will be very confident that you will definitely get a 5 in your final exam. So that's how you can prepare for the AP exams by solving the questions on the College Board website and also in the Barron's workbook. And I will say that if you are a computer science major or if you plan to take computer science, then you can consider taking AP computer science as well, because that will enable you to skip that course in college and you will be able to take some advanced level computer science classes in college early, and that can help you maybe in getting some internships because you will be able to show some advanced level experience in your resume and so on. So that covers everything, and I hope this video helps you out in graduating early by taking these AP exams. So that's pretty much it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.